First, a pair of dogs attack a carjacking suspect. And that's just one part of a very wild series of events in Daytona Beach. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm Matt Austin.
And I'm Lisa Bell. At one point, the suspect dropped his gun. A 7-year-old picked it up, then opened fire. News 6's Troy Campbell is here to walk us through all that happened, Troy.
Well, Matt, Lisa, we went to Daytona today, and we spoke with the woman who actually instructed her two dogs to attack that suspect after he had already forcibly pushed his way into her house. And law enforcement says, there's the two dogs right there. Law enforcement also says that they were searching for him for crimes that had happened just prior.
When he came in, he had his hands up, hollering, "Mama, mama, help me." I'm like, "I ain't none of your mama. What?" And I'm like, "Oh, I don't know you. Get them, girls."
Marie Gilbert says on Monday morning, she heard a knock at the door, but once she opened it slightly, she was pushed backwards after Volusia County sheriffs say 42-year-old Anthony Galloway forced his way inside. That's when she called in help from her two pit bulls, Willow and Roxy.
They grabbed him here, and the officers came in. And once they came in, they asked me to call the dogs off. And once I called the dogs off, he got up from here, and he ran here and jumped out of my kitchen window.
Moments before, investigators say Galloway was being pursued by deputies following a carjacking at a BP gas station.
He got the phone, my wallet, and everything.
This wasn't a carjacking, right? They didn't, like, throw you out of the vehicle?
No, then he just put gun out of me. I was pumping the gas at the gas station.
Wait, they put a gun at you?
Yes.
Detectives say after the dog attack inside Gilbert's apartment, Galloway ran into a business warehouse along Mason Avenue, where he refused to come out for about an hour.
Come out now with your hands up, man.
This video shows SWAT officers moving closer and then breaking open the door where Galloway barricaded himself before taking him into custody. Law enforcement says about 70 officers responded to the scene.
We would have gave you one, man. All you had to do was come out.
Then, a couple of hours later, a woman called dispatch reporting her 7-year-old son had found a gun near their apartment along the 400 block of Brentwood Drive and fired a single shot. Witnesses say this is where the bullet hit the building. The sheriff's office says the gun matches the same gun used by Galloway in the carjacking and believe he tossed it while running from deputies.
And prior to this incident, investigators say Galloway has already been charged with 67 felonies, 12 prior felony convictions. And the sheriff's office also says their detectives were able to use software, facial recognition software, to be able to identify him using the surveillance video from the BP gas station. Matt, Lisa.